nutritious green smoothie, which I have most days for breakfast because it's so full of nutrients and it's a great way to pack a lot of nutrients into your breakfast. I spent all night last night / this morning throwing up, and I had a horrible migraine, so I really need to fuel up and replenish all the nutrients that I lost. So my mom is cutting some kale, some dinosaur kale, and I'm gonna put some watercress. So it's a microgreen, it's really healthy, and it's not very common. I don't know why. We have to go to Whole Foods to find it. Every time I have watercress, I feel very hydrated, and it's very refreshing. So, and it's supposed to help the lungs. Thankfully, my breathing is a little better, but maybe because I've been drinking a lot of watercress smoothies. So, yeah, I'm also gonna put some flax oil and some mango and seeds, like flax and chia and hemp seeds. Yeah, it looks good. It's much better now. That balloon in the background is from Mother's Day. I got my mom a bunch of balloons. Thank you, Mama.
You're welcome.
I managed to finish a whole cup, almost. Here's to hoping that I hold it down long enough to absorb the nutrients, at least. Fingers crossed. I got my head out the sunroof. I'm blasting my favorite tunes. I only got one thing on my mind. You got me stuck on the thought of you. You're making me feel brand new. You're more than a sunshine in my eyes. You got those pretty eyes in your head. You know it. This stash of IVs is just from the last, 24 hours because I've been too sick to take care of this. Normally, I don't just throw my IVs on the floor like this. But my nausea was so bad this morning and last night that anytime I moved, I was throwing up. So much so that I threw up on my bed. I threw up on my bed last night and all over myself. I had to change clothes so many times, 3 times to be exact. Yeah, no fun. No fun. I have stains on everything. I literally have stains on everything. The carpet, my clothes, my bed sheets, everything. So, cyclic vomiting life for ya. I got my head out the sunroof. I'm blasting my favorite tunes. I only got one thing on my mind. You got me stuck on the thought of you. You're making me feel brand new. You're more than... I fell asleep for 4 hours, but I really needed it because I was up all night last night. Getting sick, so I'm really glad I got that nap in. You got those pretty eyes in your head, you know it. You got me dancing in my bed, so let me show it. You are exactly what I want, kinda cool and kinda not. Wanna give myself to you. Just ordered my supplies and IV hydration. I've been going through a lot more since I've been sick, so yeah, that's all taken care of, and I'm probably gonna try to eat a snack or something. It's sunnier than most days. You'll never see the sky if you keep looking down, and if you take the wrong way, and maybe you should stay instead of turning around. Mention about my gastric emptying study. I had it scheduled for last week. The night before, when I was supposed to be NPO, which I was, I spent the whole night throwing up. It was the first day of my cyclic vomiting flare. So I had to reschedule for May 26th. Luckily, they had an opening May 26th, because otherwise I probably would have had to wait longer. So I'm really bummed about that, but they wouldn't let me go because I would be throwing up. I wouldn't be able to eat the food, which is the whole point of the test, for them to measure how the food that I eat at the hospital, how it's digested, how long it takes to get digested, and all of that stuff. So I'm hoping by the 26th my vomiting will settle down and I'll be out of this flare-up. I have my GI appointment on the 23rd to discuss TPN, and I'm sure we were going to talk about the results of my gastric emptying study, but now we're just going to have to wait a few more days for that. And I'm really bummed because it's like I've already waited so long, and just the day that like I was supposed to go was when my vomiting started again. So, but I've noticed my cyclic vomiting has been once pretty much every month, because before last week it was exactly a month, actually 3.5 weeks since my last cyclic vomiting flare up. So on average I've been having my cyclical vomiting once a month, and it lasts anywhere from a day to 2 weeks. Generally it lasts about a week, so I'm hoping I'm kind of getting out of this one. I was able to hold down a little bit of food earlier, not much. At least I was able to hold it down, so that's good. And I'm still losing weight, and I'm very, very underweight. So that's between all the vomiting and nausea and not being able to eat much and losing so much weight. I'm just gonna let my doctors and my care team decide what's best for me for now and give it to God, and yeah, we'll see. So just wanted to update about that. I will take you guys along when I go to the hospital for my gastric emptying study. I have 2 more weeks, so I'm thinking by then my vomiting should settle down, since I've already been throwing up for a week and a day. So, but you keep on going. I know.
Yeah, I know. Don't stay looking out the window. And how late do you plan on going nowhere? Afraid of all the things you don't know. There's so many reasons you should care. Don't stay looking out the window. And how late do you plan on going nowhere? Afraid of all the things you don't know. There's so many.
I have another migraine, so that's why I have to wear these sunglasses inside, because I'm super light sensitive when I have migraines, and it just makes my head hurt worse, so fun stuff. Oh, sorry it's dark, y'all. I had to shut the lights off because I have a migraine from hell that does not want to go away. And if it goes away, it just comes right back. And I have been throwing up a lot, so I'm still in my cyclic vomiting flare. I was actually sick at my POTS doctor's office, and I had to leave early after only doing one test. And my mom insisted that she took me to the ER, so here I am. I'm getting some morphine and some Phenergan. Yeah, I'm getting morphine and Phenergan, and I think the morphine's helping a little, because I was at the point that I had my sunglasses on and I was just like, I could not be without my sunglasses because my head is pounding and I'm more light sensitive when I have migraines. I'm feeling so rough, so I really did not expect to end up here in this vlog, but I've been in this cyclic vomiting flare-up for over a week. Almost every day I've had really bad migraines, so definitely need to get in a neurologist and see what's going on with that, since my migraines have been much more frequent lately. Yeah, and my POTS is bad because I'm really dehydrated from all the vomiting. But like, it's crazy how much I threw up. I threw up so much, like I don't even know where it came from, because I haven't been able to eat much and it was like all liquid, and I haven't been able to drink much, so I don't know if like my IV fluids are somehow ending up in my stomach and that's what I'm throwing up. I really don't know, but yeah, that's my update for now. The good news is they were able to get a vein in my hand. It's always my hand, but I don't know if you can see. Got all my fancy armbands. Yeah, so I'm glad I'm feeling a little better. I haven't thrown up in a little while. I'll update in a little bit. Looks like I might be here for a while for observation, so probably just gonna try to take a nap. By the way, sorry about the flashes. That's the computer over there. Give you a quick little room tour. So I'm getting a potassium IV because my blood work showed my potassium was like depleted, probably from all the throwing up right there. And yeah, I'm not really surprised that it was really super, like, super low. But yeah, that was like dangerously low, so this should help with that. And yeah, I'm feeling a little better, but they're gonna give me a little more morphine, which should hopefully take it away or at least make it even better. So yeah, they just gave me my third dose of morphine, so I'm feeling pretty tired and out of it. It's helping like a little bit each time, so maybe the third time will be the charm. Fingers crossed. They have to monitor my blood pressure really closely because apparently morphine can give you dangerously low blood pressure. And I have POTS, so my blood pressure goes from dangerously high to dangerously low. It's always swinging. But generally it's high these days, so I told him maybe this is the one and only time that's a good thing to have high blood pressure. That way, if morphine lowers it, I should be safe and not go into hypervolemic shock because my blood pressure is super high. It's too bad I couldn't stay for my whole POTS appointment because that was one of the things I was going to talk to my cardiologist about, getting another blood pressure and heart medication to replace the bisoprolol and metoprolol that I had to stop because it was making my anaphylactic reactions from mast cell activation worse. I noticed when I stopped taking the bisoprolol and metoprolol, which is for my heart and blood pressure, that my breathing and mast cell activation got a little better. So, but now my tachycardia and blood pressure is out of control, so I'm gonna have to call back and reschedule tomorrow, and hopefully I can get in soon and on a day that I'm not too sick and that I can actually make it through the appointment.
This is the same amount of morphine. It's 4 milligrams. All right. You let me know how that works for you, or if you don't feel all right, okay?
Thank you.
I'm gonna turn off the light and you hit your call bell if you need me or if you feel okay and stuff like that, okay?
Okay, thank you. I got my head out the sunroof. I'm blasting my favorite tunes. Hey, so I am back from the hospital. It was a pretty short stay. It was 5 days. My phone, oh my gosh, so like I totally forgot about getting my phone charger when I went to the ER. Honestly, I didn't think I was going to be admitted at all, so I didn't bring my phone charger, and my mom couldn't find my phone charger, so my phone was dead for like 3 out of the 5 days that I was there. And they usually have like chargers at the hospital, but they didn't have any charger for my phone. So it felt a lot longer than it was. But then again, I did like, I don't know, I was really out of it like the whole time too. So I probably wouldn't have been able to be on my phone because I was really light sensitive. And I was just like, I had to be like under the covers the whole time with my sunglasses on and as little stimulation as possible. So they tried as much as they could for the first like 4 days. Like I had so much morphine because the morphine was like helping a little, but not that much. It would help a little and then it would get back like really bad again. So they gave me morphine until eventually it like stopped working. They gave me dilaudid, toradol. Those didn't help. Eventually they ended up trying a combination, like a cocktail, they called it an IV cocktail for migraines, and it was compazine, Benadryl to offset the side effects of compazine, because compazine makes people feel really agitated and like you want to crawl out of your skin. The Benadryl did not help those side effects for me. I still had awful side effects from the compazine. They mixed it with magnesium, and when they mixed the compazine with magnesium and Benadryl, that actually helped my migraine. So I ended up having so many infusions. I had potassium because my potassium was critically low. The magnesium I had a couple times, but when they mixed the magnesium with the compazine and Benadryl, that seemed to do it. It downgraded my migraine to a headache. and I was able to be discharged. So I'm so grateful that I'm home. I actually got home yesterday. I spent the day sleeping. I was so tired because I never sleep in the hospital. Like I was just so out of it the whole time, but I didn't really get any like solid sleep, which I never do. Thankfully, it was a short stay for me. I usually stay in the hospital a lot longer. I'm just glad to be home. I'm so grateful my migraine is finally gone. I still have this headache that's lingering, so I'm really hoping it won't rebound. They did say that that's common, that they see rebound, so let's hope that's not happening. My cyclic vomiting flare seems to be on its way out. I haven't thrown up in 3 days. Of course, I'm still nauseous, but I do have my medicine at home, so I'm so grateful to be home. Yeah, my cyclic vomiting flare is better, and hopefully my migraine is gone for a while. And if you see this rash, it's just a mast cell rash. I'm still flared up with my mast cell activation, although I haven't had anaphylaxis in a couple weeks, thankfully. I'm still following a strict low histamine diet, which has been helping. And I'm just taking a break from like all the meds because they kind of stopped working, unfortunately. But I'll do an update about that in another video soon. I just wanted to wrap up this vlog because it's probably been long enough as it is. I did not expect to end up in the hospital at all. I didn't expect to end up in the ER, but my mom insisted, and then I got a surprise admission. Thankfully, I'm feeling a little better now, and I'm just gonna spend the weekend resting and trying to take care of myself since I've kind of neglected that for the last couple weeks since I've been in my vomiting flare and had so many migraines. Oh my gosh. I'm gonna have to schedule an appointment with a neurologist. I haven't been in with a neurologist in years because I used to have common like migraines all the time since I was a kid, since I was just 4. It kept me out of school a lot. And it was a big issue growing up, but then they kind of stopped for a while, and then they kind of creep back in the last few years, but they weren't that frequent until I would say the last few months. The last 2-3 months they've been getting more frequent, and that's obviously not fun. So hopefully we can get to the bottom of this and find something that I can take at home. So it got really bad. It felt like a sledgehammer just pounding and pounding, and the light was making it worse. I was just so nauseous. And I threw up so much. I'm so grateful to be home. I'm gonna appreciate all the things that I have at home, my mom, my cat, and all the little joys that I have surrounding me. And yeah, thank you so much for watching this vlog. It means so much to me. Please give it a like, that really helps. And yeah, hit the bell for notifications if you haven't already. And I love you to pieces. I'll see you next time. Bye.
It's sunnier than most days. You'll never see the sky if you keep looking down. And if you take the wrong way, and maybe you should stay instead of turning around.